Here we'll study the force acting on a particle in elliptical trajectory, and we are required to find the force, magnitude and direction acting on a particle of mass m moving in xy plane according to the relation given by these expressions of displacements in x and y directions. Here if we just have a look on these displacements, here we use as x is equals to a sine of omega t and y is equals to a cos of omega t. From here we can calculate the velocity of particle in x direction and velocity of particle in y direction by differentiating these values dx by dt and dy by dt. So these values are a omega cos of omega t and minus b omega sine of omega t. Now in this situation, if we further differentiate it, you can see acceleration in x direction would be minus a omega square sine omega t and ay is minus b omega square cos omega t. So from this relation here we can see, if we square and add, then this can be given as x square by a square plus y square by b square is equals to 1. Before squaring, you need to take these a and b on the left hand side in denominator and then square and add. So right hand side will be unity and left hand side is this. So this is the equation of trajectory, which you can see this is an equation of ellipse. So this will be elliptical path in which the particle is moving. And if we calculate the force on particle, then force on particle can be given as MA vector, that is a total force in magnitude and direction. So here this force vector we can write as M, and A vector is given by these components. So this minus A omega square sine omega t I cap minus b omega square cos omega t j cap, or this can also be written as minus m omega square and this a sine omega t I cap plus b cos omega t j cap. And here we can see a sine omega t and b cos omega t are the positions of particle in x and y directions. So here f vector can directly be written as minus m omega square r vector, where r vector is the position of particle, position vector of particle with respect to origin. So this is the final result of problem, and here you can see as force is acting opposite to r vector, this is a central force acting on particle always toward the reference point which we are taking as origin. So this will be the final result of this problem.